Somebody help me! I need a flight effect!
Welcome back to our Superman flight tutorial miniseries. That's a mouthful. This is the fourth tutorial in our sequence, so if you haven't checked out the previous ones, go do it. What are you waiting for? Today we're going to be jumping into Blender and using a cloth simulation to create a cape for our Superman to wear. If you've not used Blender before, I highly recommend checking out our Blender masterclass. We go through the entire interface and build our first model together so you can completely come to grips with Blender and how to integrate it into your HitFilm workflow. So without further ado, let's do it. I have Blender already open, and the first thing we're going to do is select all the default items with A and delete them with X. For our cape, we're going to be using a simple plane and morph it into what we need. Start off by adding a plane by pressing Shift and A to bring up the add menu, go into mesh and drop down a plane. I'm going to keep my forces aligned to the Z axis, so I'm going to rotate this 90 degrees on the Y and scale it up a bit. At the moment, this is too square, so change this into more of a trapeze shape. Let's jump into edit mode by hitting tab, and if we come up here and click the edge selection tool, we can grab this top edge and hit S to scale it down a touch. By keeping the bottom wider, this will leave the cape open and able to flow with the wind. While we're still in edit mode, select all of your object with A, right click and hit subdivide. Head over to this tab and open it up. Let's increase the number of cuts to 50. The more you have, the slower your sim may take, but higher the resolution and detail. So feel free to do more or less depending on your cape needs. Now before we start simulating, we'll first need some pins for the cloth to hold onto. So instead of jumping back into object mode, we'll move into weight paint. Before I talk you through, open up the vertex group properties, this triangle shaped one here. Vertex groups are for assigning properties and areas, and a way to create these groups is with weight paint. Move your mouse over the plane and click over the two corners that would be the shoulders. You'll know that you have them selected once they go red. You'll also see that a new group has been created. Let's rename that group Pins. So let's jump into object mode and start, shall we? Have your object selected? Open the physics options and select cloth. If we press play, you'll notice our cloth just falls. Open the shape dropdown and set the pin group to the one we've just made. Play it through again and it'll bounce and dangle in place. It's like Superman left his cape out to dry on the hanger. Let's add some motion to get this a bit more interesting. Shift and A, head into force and find wind. In our end effect, we have Superman flying at great speed, so the force would be coming from mainly one direction. This is what we'll be aiming for. Move the force above the shoulders and rotate to the direction we're after. We can go ahead and increase the strength number to something more suitable for the high speeds of Superman, like 8,000. It's bouncing quite a lot on the shoulders here, so I'm going to jump into weight paint again and add a little extra along this edge. No need to change anything, as it will automatically update when we reset the timeline of playthrough. When you're happy with your simulation, head into the cache dropdown and bake the data. While we're waiting on that to render, you should consider subscribing to our YouTube channel for more tutorials like the one that you're watching and enjoying right now. It only takes a second, and probably in the same time it takes you to bake this render. I'll throw you back in. With the bake complete, it's a case of preparing your file for compositing. Add a subdivision surface to smooth out any details. Add some material for your cape, some lights to match your scene, orientating a camera to the position that fits our actor's plate. Finally, rendering it out as a PNG with alpha. Enable transparent in the rendering icon to ensure the background is removed. We can now jump into HitFilm Express and import our cape render by selecting Import Image Sequence. If you've seen and followed our setup tutorial, you'll notice that we place tracking markers on our suit for this cape. Track both markers, apply the data to a point, and parent the cape to that point layer. That's it, up, up and away! If you're looking to composite this into a flight effect, why not check out our previous tutorial and learn to fly? If you've been following along with our other tutorials, now that you've got your cape, you can tie them all together to create this Superman sequence. Be sure to subscribe, hit the like button, and let us know in the comment section down below, what superhero effect would you want to see next? What would you want to see a complete miniseries on? What superhero have we not covered before? Let us know.